Welcome back. Today I want to share a very important thing. Many viewers asked me earlier to share how I am implementing cut in and cut out speed in wind generation. That is very important. We know that we have to show how our wind generation system is performing while cut in and cut out speed. Generally, we know what is cut in speed. Cut in speed means where the system will start generation of electricity in wind generation system, and cut out speed is the speed at which our generation system will stop generating electricity. So the problem is that we are working in simulation. We are not developing three-dimensional structure. So how to implement this with this simulation work? So maybe different people are using different practice. What I am using, that I am going to share with you, and hope you will appreciate this and you will also use. So this is my previous work, what I had shared with you all. Now I will copy this much. And I will create a new here. I want to remove all this because I don't want to go in much impact what is going here and there. Many questions will arise. So that is not the part here. That's why I'm going to remove all this. So just here I will apply a simple RLC branch so that thing should be clear. Okay, because basic things I'm going to discuss here. And here I have to take a ground. Okay, now I will put it minimum resistive load I will take, so that little bit is here. And yes, okay, sorry, it will not be here, it should be here. Okay, so just I have to go here, and you know all what configuration I'm using, so same configuration I will use here. Here I will take 10 power minus 6 apply. So just run it. So it is working. Okay. Sorry. In my earlier video, it was here. It was what, 12. The rated speed was 12 and it was working like this. So now I am going to remove it, and I want to give a different means variable speed. Okay, variable wind speed. So the speed would be different sometimes. How it is, I'm going to show you. This is the speed profile. Okay, here it is maximum, I think 15, more than 15, and minimum is here, that is less than a 4. Okay, so this type of wind will be applied. Okay, so in this one, what I will consider, speed, low speed means 4 or 5, I will consider as low speed or cut-in speed, and more than 14 I will consider cut-out speed. Okay, so how we will implement that, that is the important thing which I want to say with you. So what I will do, just I will enter inside this here, and first I will unlock it. After unlocking this, here I will develop a logical circuit. Okay, so how I will develop, just watch it. So I will take a switch, okay, and one more switch I will take here. So what speed is coming, here the speed is coming, so that would be the reference. So what speed I am going to take as cutting, suppose 5, means when the speed is greater than or equal 5 meters per second, the generation will start. Okay, and what speed I am going to take as cutout, that is suppose I am going to take as 40. Okay, 14 meter per second, if the speed will be more than 40 or is equal more than 40 meter per second, the generator will stop generation. So this I will take here. Okay, so now develop the logic. So when the speed is more than greater than or equal 5, it will pass. If it is greater than, okay, so then this signal will be passed, otherwise it will pass 0. Okay, your wind turbine will think that the speed is 0, otherwise. Now, if next this is the speed, so here it will come. Okay, this is the speed, so here it will come. So up to 14, okay, if it is greater than 14, it should pass 0. So what will happen, if condition satisfied, then it will pass 0. Okay, and if condition is not satisfied, it will pass this. Okay, now where this signal we have to give, so what I will do, I will modify this one and I will put it here to, and I will modify here also, and just keep it here, this one here, and do one more thing. So give it 0. Okay, so this one was velocity q. So now I made it square, and one velocity is coming here, so total will be velocity q. After doing this, just I'm going back, and now I will run it. Okay, what is going to happen, I will show you, just wait. So torque, first one is torque. So see here, this was during this time, means let me clear it. Okay. I will take a scope where I will show you two things from. I will give name of this one is wind velocity V. Take it here, I will keep it, and this is the torque. Okay, so now run it and observe here what is going to happen. Okay, so first one is torque and second signal is speed. So with respect to speed, our torque is varying. Okay, so during this time, speed is more than 14. Okay, so when speed is more than 14, that means it is cut out speed. So during cutout speed, your generator, means your turbine, is giving no torque to the generator. So definitely generator will reduce small or zero power. And during this time, see here, 20 to 24, during time interval 20 to 24, during this time the speed is below 5. Okay, so when the speed is below 5, at that time also your wind turbine is giving zero torque to the generator. Means at that time generator also will produce small power or zero power. Okay, so in this way easily we can implement cut in and cut out speed in our simulation of wind energy system. All these parameters taken from this PMSG parameter, wind turbine parameter, and this all have taken from my previous video, and that was regarding wind MPPT, wind energy generation system. So go there and you can watch, but I don't think that you need to watch that video for this regard, because it's just you implement what I'm showing you here with your any model of turbine. Okay, so just implement this there, it will work. And this signal also, how to develop, I had made already that video, so please watch that video and you can make it your own. Now some important thing what I would like to clear, that this method will be applied with any wind turbine. Okay, the thing is that if you in this case I'm using a system which is PMSG direct driven wind turbine. So when below cut in speed, your turbine will give zero torque, so power of the PMSG also will be zero. But if you will use the gear train, at that time you will observe that even though your cut in and cut out speed is applied, at that time your generator will produce power. Okay, but lower power compared to in general case without cut in and cut out speed, what power it should generate, compared to that it will produce less power so that your system will be protected. I will request all of you to apply that with my previous video what I had shared regarding PMSG with direct drive, sorry, gear train. With that model you apply it, and there you will observe what is the need of a drive train in case of wind turbine generation. Okay, so hope this video will benefit to you, and please subscribe my channel and like the videos and share among your friend, so that if even though it is not good, maybe small knowledgeable, maybe, but that would be benefit for some. Thank you. Thank you very much.